जैसे हम लोग वहाँ निकले, उन्होंने फिर उसको भी नहीं देखा और जो भी हो सकता था इनके पास लाठी डंडे तलवार उसे हमला कर दिया।
दिल्ली के रास्ते तो लाल किले का रास्ता किसान को पता है, जब वहां के खुले हुए रास्ते तो हो गए, आप कहेंगे से खुले तो किसान जाते रहा, किसान तो अनपढ़ है।
भारतीय जनता पार्टी की केंद्र में बैठी नरेंद्र मोदी की सरकार जिम्मेदार है क्योंकि उन्होंने स्थिति को इतना खराब होने दिया।
एएसआई के उच्च अधिकारियों के साथ लाल किले का भ्रमण किया है और मैंने दो निर्देश दिए हैं, तत्काल रिपोर्ट बनाई जाए और वो गृह मंत्रालय को सौंपी जाए।
उन लोगों के साथ आज हम बैठ के आगे आंदोलन नहीं चला सकते जिनकी दिशा अलग हो।
Everyone, you're watching News Epicenter with me, Maria Shakil. It has been over 24 hours since the national capital witnessed unprecedented scenes. A peaceful mass movement lasting for over 60 days has lost its sanctity. On the 72nd Republic Day of India, the anarchists brought shame to the very ethos of this nation, where every voice is heard, every person respected, and every opinion registered. The symbol of India's pride, the Red Fort, was breached yesterday, and what followed thereafter was sheer anarchy. Sticks, swords, a stolen police gun, and to top it all, tractors and bulldozers were used to break barricades, topple police vans, and damage public property. All this in what was promised to be a peaceful demonstration. Vandals or farmers, the lines are becoming more blurred than ever before. As a result of this universal condemnation that has followed, the Kisan unions are slowly retreating and withdrawing from this agitation, the purpose of which clearly stands sullied. Two farmer unions, the All India Kisan Sangharsh Coordination Committee and the Bharatiya Kisan Union Bhanu faction, have stepped back as a result of the violence which shocked the nation's conscience. Even though these leaders are dissociating from what they call violent anti-social elements, what cannot be ignored is that every single protester is responsible for what happened yesterday and will have to face the consequences. The crux of the matter is that a leaderless movement which stood its ground against the government over the controversial farm laws has now become directionless and slipped into rudderlessness. This was the golden opportunity for farmers to register their protest peacefully. However, what the rioters have left is a blot on the democracy. So the big question is, after rejecting every single offer and going on a rampage on the streets of the capital, is there scope for a Kisan government dialogue? Have the farmers now lost the moral high ground? Let me bring in my guests now. Atar Singh Sandhu is national president of Bharatiya Kisan Union. We have Neeraj Kumar, former commissioner of police of Delhi. Gurcharan Das, economist. Adil Singh Boparai, spokesperson of the Congress Party. Zafar Islam representing the BJP. Neeraj Kumar, the Delhi police certainly showed restraint, otherwise this kind of protest could have turned bloody. The question is, if the cops had intelligence inputs that the tractor rally would deviate from its stated route, and the sound bites that have been given by the various farmer leaders clearly says that they will be marching to the Red Fort, then why was the permission given in the first place?
No, the permission was given on a pre-decided route. But the farmers did not adhere to that route. They did not adhere to the timings given. In fact, my theory is that they left the borders that early because the intention was to disturb the Republic Day parade itself. And had it not been for the resistance offered by the police, they would have definitely reached the Rajpath and tried to disturb the Republic Day parade itself. So the question of having not having prior intelligence is not there. It was a solemn promise made by the farmer leaders that they would adhere to the timings, they would adhere to the routes, and they would follow all the instructions. They had even volunteered to have their own people marshal the rally and so on and so forth. But none of those conditions were followed. They left much before time with the clear intention to reach, I feel, Rajpath. The fact that they reached the ITO is a clear enough indication that their intentions were anything but holy.
संधू जी जवाब दीजिए इसका. ये साफ तौर पर दिख रहा है कि ये लार्जर कंस्पिरेसी का हिस्सा है.
जो परमिशन दी थी, जो एग्रीमेंट हुआ था पुलिस और किसानों के बीच में, वो ये हुआ था कि भाई बैरिकेड रात को हटा दिए जाएंगे. पुलिस प्रशासन ने बैरिकेड को रात को नहीं हटाया. 10 बजे तक भी बैरिकेड कुछ एरिया में नहीं हटे थे और जो रूट हमें रूट दिए गए थे उसी का हमने पालन किया है. जब बैरिकेड नहीं हटाए पुलिस ने तो फिर तो टकराव बढ़ेगा ना. पुलिस को अपनी जिम्मेदारी का निर्वाह नहीं किया पुलिस ने.
आपने कौन सी जिम्मेदारी निभा दी?
तो किसान बिल्कुल भी उग्र नहीं होता. और मेरा ये मानना है कि जो लाल किले पर है उसके लिए बिल्कुल हम कंडम करते हैं. जो जिसने भी किया उसको पर कार्रवाई होनी चाहिए. लाल किले पर जो भी हुआ वो दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण है. वो किसी किसान ने नहीं किया, ना वो किसान नेता थे, वो तो बीजेपी के लोग थे. वो साबित हो चुका है कि
आपके नेता कहाँ थे? आपके नेता उस वक्त कहाँ थे जब ये पूरा फार्मर ग्रुप लाल किले में घुस रहा था? कहाँ थे राकेश टिकैत?
देखिए राकेश, ना तो राकेश टिकैत के वो लोग थे, ना जो 40 संगठन है किसानों के, ना उनके लोग थे.
जब आपका पूरा मूवमेंट आउट ऑफ कंट्रोल हो गया है तो मूवमेंट कंट्रोल
खंडन करते हैं.
नहीं, लेकिन मेरा सवाल सुनिए, पूरा सवाल सुनिए, पूरा सवाल सुनिए.
संगठन से जुड़ा हुआ ना हमारे से,
सवाल सुनिए,
हमारे संगठन से जुड़ा हुआ.
मुझे ये बताइए कि अगर ये पूरा मूवमेंट आउट ऑफ कंट्रोल है तो मूवमेंट कंटिन्यू क्यों हो रहा है?
पुलिस प्रशासन ने,
चलिए आपका आवाज अब बंद होगा क्योंकि आप सवाल ही नहीं सुन रहे. मोनोलॉग के लिए थोड़ी ना आए यहाँ पर.
पुलिस का प्रशासन तंत्र,
गुरचरण दास ना ऑन द स्क्रीन प्लीज. गुरचरण दास, द वायलेंस हैज हर्ट मोस्ट ऑफ ऑल द फार्मर्स प्रोटेस्ट एंड द मूवमेंट. इट डील्स अ ब्लो टू व्हाट वाज द कॉलिंग कार्ड टिल नाउ. That it has been a peaceful protest. Then what next? Can there be a dialogue?
Well, clearly this is a turning point. And the farmers who had garnered so much sympathy sitting in the winter, peacefully in Delhi, amongst the public, that sympathy has been lost. And instead of those wonderful images of their sacrifice in the winter, now will be replaced in the public mind with that picture of the flag flying, the yellow flag flying of the Red Fort. That will be what will be remembered. That will be the memory. So if you are a farmer protester, you're obviously very unhappy. But if you are an economist and a reformer, you feel that this is in some ways fortunate that now the government does not have to be on the back foot. You know, just 2 days ago, I was feeling very bad because the government had said that we will now, for a year and a half,
yes,
we won't meant these reforms. I mean, I thought this was all over. And I felt the government had also given away too much. I mean, for example, they had said, all right, you can spoil the air of North India. We won't take any action on stubble burning. They said you can have free electricity. When we know that the electricity boards have to be reformed, they are in serious trouble. And in fact, the reality is, you know, I'm a Punjabi, and My father helped bring water through Bhakra Dam as an engineer in the canals. And so I'm a proud Punjabi, but Punjabis can be pig-headed also. Here was something that is good for them in the long term. And they were
so now the point that you're trying to make is that the government gave all possible concessions. Sandhu sahab, iska bhi jawab dijiye. Jitna offer ho sakta tha table par, unhone sab rakh diya. Aapka moral position us waqt ban sakta tha. Jab sarkar ne ye bola ki 1.5 saal tak ke liye ye law abhi hold par bhi dal denge. Kal ke baad kya hai? Kaun si sympathy ab aapke saath rahegi?
देखिए मारिया जी, मैं तो देखिए मैं इस कल के एपिसोड को दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण मानता हूं। पूरी तरह से किसान 2 महीने से दिल्ली की सड़कों पर ठंड में बैठा था। हमारे 180 किसान इस आंदोलन में शहीद हो चुके हैं। सरकार ने एक बार भी कंडोलेंस नहीं किया, किसी किसान के प्रति सद्भावना व्यक्त नहीं की, तो कैसे विश्वास करें सरकार का? सरकार ने तो रेवाड़ी की रैली में यह भी कहा था, नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने, स्वामीनाथन की आयोग की रिपोर्ट जैसे मैं सरकार में आऊंगा सीटू के आधार पर लागू करूंगा। जब सरकार को स्वामीनाथन आयोग की रिपोर्ट देने का वादा हुआ तो सरकार ने सुप्रीम कोर्ट में एफिडेविट दे दिया, हम सीटू के आधार पर, सीटू प्लस 50 के आधार पर हम नहीं दे सकते। तो सरकार की मंशा पर तो हमेशा सवाल खड़े हुए,
लेकिन मंशा पर अब तो आपकी मंशा पर सवाल उठे रहे हैं ना। कल की घटना के बाद अब तो ये क्वेश्चन किया जा रहा है कि जब आपका इस मूवमेंट पे कंट्रोल ही नहीं है, जो लोग लाल किले पे चढ़ करके झंडा, कोई तिरंगा हटा करके कोई और झंडा फहरा सकते हैं, वो आपके कंट्रोल में नहीं है, तो आपका कैसे विश्वास किया जाए? अब सरकार किससे बात करेगी? आपके ही दो ग्रुप हैं वो हट चुके हैं।
देखिए मारिया, मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ, कोई भी किसी किसान ने, आप एक किसान नेता का नाम गिनाइए जिसने झंडा फहराया हो, जिसका, जिसके लोग वहाँ लाल किले पे हो। हम तो ये कहते हैं ये कहीं ना कहीं सरकार की बहुत बड़ी साजिश है।
चलिए जफर इस्लाम रिस्पॉन्ड ऑन दिस। यू नो जफर इस्लाम, द पॉइंट बीइंग मेड अबाउट दीप सिंधु
और सरकार हु इज ओके वन मोमेंट बदनाम। देखिए पूरे दुनिया से आज किसान को सम्पत्ति मिल रही थी, आज किसान को बदनाम करने की बहुत बड़ी साजिश थी, सरकार उसमें कामयाब
हुई। जफर इस्लाम नाउ कम इन ऑन दिस।
हम तो प्रजातंत्र पे विश्वास कर रखने वाले लोग हैं, हमने सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने हमें कहा भी किसानों बिल्कुल शांतिपूर्वक बैठने का आपका अधिकार है।
तो बार बार सब लोग बोल रहा था कि आप शांतिपूर्ण प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हैं, लेकिन अब देखिए क्या हो गया।
ये नहीं पता था,
और उसके लिए जिम्मेदारी तो आपको लेनी पड़ेगी। आज के बाद वो जो सिंपैथी था वो अब नहीं रहेगा आपके साथ। दीप सिंधु, जफर इस्लाम इज समवन हु इज नाउ अंडर द स्कैनर ऑफ द NIA फॉर फॉरेन फंडिंग। He has been part of these protests from day one. He was also among those who were present at the Red Fort yesterday. The question is, if the government agencies had inputs of his Khalistani connect, then why has he been given a long rope? Why no FIR and why hasn't he been arrested so far? Zafar.
देखिए मारिया, टुडे आई विल प्रीफर टू स्पीक इन हिंदी बिकॉज द जेंटलमैन हैज रिक्वेस्टेड दैट बेस्ट वी स्पीक इन हिंदी सो दैट ही कैन ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड। मारिया, सबसे पहली बात है कि आप सारे किसान यूनियन के जो लीडर बन रहे थे, जिन्होंने बार बार आश्वासन दिया था कि, और लिखित रूप में दिया था आश्वासन, साइन किया था, अंडरटेकिंग दिया था कि हम कोई भी चीज नहीं होने देंगे, हम हर जो भी ट्रैक्टर आएगा सब ट्रैक्टर के रिकॉर्ड है हमारे पास, ट्रैक्टर पर कौन बैठेगा और हम मॉनिटर करेंगे, हमारे पास वॉलंटियर्स है मॉनिटर करने के लिए, एक आदमी भी नहीं। वो वॉलंटियर्स के नाम पे ये सारे जो है, जो जितने जो पदवी थे उस सबको उनमें डाल दिया वॉलंटियर्स के नाम पे और सबको साथ भेजा। ये सब इनके प्लान जो है, खासकर प्लान किया था। अब कैमरे में बहुत सारी चीजें जो आ रही हैं जो पहले उन्होंने रिकॉर्ड की थी, हो सकता था उन्होंने पहले बोला हो ये, लेकिन जब प्रशासन से बात हुई, पुलिस से बात हुई, तो ये दंगाइयों को उस वक्त, ये दंगाई है उस वक्त उन्होंने दूसरा स्टैंड लिया और पुलिस को बिल्कुल कमिटमेंट किया कि हम इस तरह से करेंगे, इस तरह से करेंगे, हम सब कुछ फॉलो करेंगे, सारे NOC पे साइन किया। लेकिन ये दंगाई थे असल में, और इन्होंने दंगाई का काम किया है। और आज ये इतने साल, इतने महीने तक सिंपैथी लेने की कोशिश कर रहे थे, लेकिन अब पूरे दुनिया में इन्होंने जिस तरह से
शर्मसार किया देश को,
उससे इनको सख्ती से निपटा जाएगा। सुन लीजिए संधु जी, आपने पूरे देश को शमशार किया, पूरे दुनिया में आप लोगों ने जो काम किया है, आप सिंपैथी की क्या बात करें? आज सरकार आपके सामने झुक के हर तरह से सपोर्ट कर रही थी, आप लोगों ने उसका नाजायज फायदा उठाया। अब सख्ती से सरकार, कल अगर सरकार गोली चलाने का, अगर गोली चलाने का सरकार इजाजत दे देती तो आप कितने लोग मर जाते आपको पता है? सरकार और पुलिस को जो प्रशासन थे उनको बधाई देनी चाहिए, उन लोगों ने जिस तरह से लाठियां अपने पे खाई, पुलिस वालों ने लाठियां खाई लेकिन उन्होंने गोलियां नहीं बरसाई। गोलियां बरसाते तो आज ये बोलने के लिए खड़े नहीं होते कि कैंट जी क्या बोलते थे।
परमिशन मांगी थी
आपको जेल के सलाखों के अंदर आपको ठोकाई होगी। आप
एक रात पहले क्या प्लानिंग कर सकता है क्या? जिस प्लानिंग को हम करके चले थे उसको
तो आप तो क्यों कर रहे थे 26 तारीख को? कितनी बार बना दिया क्या 26 तारीख को मत कीजिए? आपकी प्लानिंग में गलती थी। अभी आप खुद लीजिए, आप जैसे जो दंगाई है ये मुखौटा पहन के जो आप लोग कांग्रेस के इशारे पे नाच रहे हैं, कांग्रेस के इशारे पे और बाकी अपोजिशन पार्टी के इशारे पे नाच रहे हैं, अब आप लोग को देखिए समझ में आएगा
आदिल
कि आप लोगों को सख्ती से निपटा जाएगा। आप लोगों ने देश को
जिन लोगों ने प्रोटेस्टर्स कंटिन्यू टू से
दैट दिस सरकार आप सख्ती से निपटा देगी। आप बता दीजिए आप ये अपना
इंटरेस्ट ऑफ फूल अगर यू विल हैव टू म्यूट देयर
वॉइसेस।
आपको आपको पहली बार जैसे चौरी चौरा का इंसिडेंट हुआ था गांधी जी ने उस पर कहा था कि भाई ये पांच लोग मरे हैं तो चलो पुलिस वाले
जफर आदिल नाउ प्लीज। यस आदिल
Maria, the events of yesterday is a conspiracy by the Bharatiya Janata Party to defame the farmer movement. Please ask yourself this question: who stands to gain from discrediting this pious and peaceful movement? Who stands to gain from sullying the good name of this farmer movement? Who seeks to distract public attention from the core demands of the farmers? Who allowed the situation to reach such a pass that these antisocial elements succeeded in reaching the Red Fort? And one question which perhaps you forgot to ask Mr. Zafar Islam, that what are Deep Sidhu's links with the Bharatiya Janata Party? Since I hail from Punjab, let me, for the benefit of your viewers, tell you that Deep Sidhu was the virtually de facto member of parliament of the BJP from Gurdaspur. He was the constituency in charge of the BJP for the Gurdaspur parliamentary seat. So these are pertinent questions. Certain antisocial elements were planted to distract and defame this movement. The farmer leaders 2 days before this tractor rally were on record to say that certain elements have infiltrated. What were the agencies doing? Did the Home Minister allow the situation to reach this pass so that subsequently he can use his frontal organizations to launch a media blitzkrieg to disgrace the farmers, to defame the farmers?
Zafar, respond
These
to
are
this
pertinent
charge.
Questions. 180 farmers have lost their lives, Maria. 180 farmers. They were protesting for the past 6 months.
Okay, Zafar, now
this
respond.
Media blitzkrieg will not help them. The farmers' resolve is further strengthened. Let me tell you,
I want
the
to
more the media tries to push Maria,
after
the
yesterday,
the more our resolve is strengthened.
No, but Adil, tell
Maria,
me one thing, one moment.
10 seconds. I want to show you something to your viewers, that who is this man? Who is this? He's talking about Bharatiya Janata Party. He must introspect what this man is doing with Rahul Gandhi. Just show this to everyone, what
Mr.
this man
Zafar
is doing
Islam,
with Rahul Gandhi. He is the man
Mr.
who was the
Zafar
first person
Islam
to stop the tractor. He was the man who was... working against the policemen there at ITO. He is the man who is responsible for mayhem at ITO. And he is associate of Rahul Gandhi. We must show many more pictures.
Prime Minister. There are photographs of him
soon,
with the
soon,
Home
some
Minister.
More, some more
who is benefiting Maria?
Soon, some more
who is benefiting from defaming the farmers? Soon. I ask you this question today, Maria. Who is benefiting from defaming the farmer
Maria,
movement?
Maria,
who
I
is
think,
benefiting
I
from
think,
maligning
I
the farmer movement?
Congress
it is
party
Narendra
will have
Modi
to,
and
Congress
the
party will have to respond.
Who is benefiting from
to,
defaming
they
the
will
farmers?
Have to respond to many questions.
If they had
inputs,
why did
Congress,
they not take
Congress
action?
Congress party and Rahul Gandhi.
Why did
who
they
is this
not
man?
Take action?
Who is responsible for mayhem at
Sidhu and company
ITO?
Have a free
and this man is responsible and he is an associate of Rahul Gandhi.
He will heckle me. They will use the media to defame the farmers. They will use the media to call them the anti-nationals. But Mr. Zafar Islam,
you are oblivious of our history.
No, but Adil, one moment now.
Adil,
I am asking you one question now today. After what happened yesterday, and opposition parties have condemned. But the larger question is, is this...
No,
Adil, one moment. My question now is that because this movement has evidently become a leaderless movement which has gone out of control. That is what the farmer unions are saying. Although in this movement now, there are questions being raised about whether this is in the interest of the farmers at all or not. But Adil, the question is again that your party backed farm reforms. Only now because you are in opposition, your stand has changed. Can you say that these reforms are not in the interest of the farmers? When you backed these reforms and only recently,
I expect 60
Congress,
seconds.
One moment, Congress Chief Minister of Punjab, Ms. Captain Amrinder Singh's government's report talked about these reforms, saying that they are the need of the hour. What changed?
Well, Maria, let me, for the benefit of yours, put this on record, that we were in favor and we are still in favor of creating more regulated markets. We are not in favor of creating unregulated markets. But let this point not lost, let be lost in this melee that who stands to gain from standing the good name of the farmers? Who stands to gain from discrediting the farmer movement? The answer is simple to any objective, independent and rational voice that it is the BJP which allowed the situation to reach this pass and they seek to gain politically.
Can I just respond?
Okay, yes, Zafar will respond now.
From the core demands of the farmers. And no amount
but
of media...
But one and a half years... First of all, the laws have been put on hold for 1.5 years already. That is what the government's proposal
is. Repeal them.
Why repeal laws which are in the interest of the farmers?
Re-enact.
Go ahead, Zafar.
The laws, the government of India
Maria,
has acknowledged that
Maria,
there are several
first
flaws.
Of all, first
then
of all,
what is the difficulty
Adil,
in repealing
Adil,
these laws?
Adil, Mr. Adil,
Narendra
listen
Modi
to me, you have spoken.
Narendra Modi and the Home Minister allowed the situation to reach this pass.
Are
and nobody
about,
seems to be asking
forget about
the
your
Home Minister
statement. Talk about
who
your own
is
party.
Accountable
don't talk about BJP.
For the law and
let
order
me tell
in
you a
state,
few things which is important for you to know.
The BJP is
I want you to know
a
few important things which I think you should know about your party. In 2007, Finance Commission report recommended all these things which has come. Which has not been part of the bill,
the
and your party
failed?
Had accepted it.
Put your hand on
it
your
is
heart,
the
Maria.
Swaminathan Commission
the
report, which your party and your Sarkar, your government has accepted it. Why
okay.
did you reject
the
it? Why did you reject those recommendations?
I'm going to bring
you would have rejected
Neeraj Kumar and Gurcharan Das now on the screens because, away
reality,
from politics,
you
the larger question is of these laws and also the law and order situation that has emerged out of what played out. Neeraj Kumar. The fact is that the questions will be raised about should the permission have been given in the first place. But the permission was given and we saw how events played out. Given the kind of history that Punjab has had of separatist movement, is this riding tiger and who is really riding a tiger here?
Oh, I find this question a little awkward because see, if we had not given permission to the farmers to carry out this rally, what you saw in the city would have unfolded right at the borders. And what would have happened at the borders? The farmers would have insisted on getting into the city. There would have been confrontation. And to stop them there, eventually a situation would have arisen when the police would have had to open fire, which would have become a very, very tragic situation. See, the strategy of the police, I presume, was that it is better to allow them to come into the city, to let them take a rally as per a route agreed upon and allow the things to finish off peacefully. Well, if there was any intelligence that it is going to turn out to be this way, no sensible police officer would have given this permission. But it was a gentleman's agreement between the farmer unions and the police that you would leave the borders at this point of time, you would follow this route, so many number of tractors would be there, so many number of volunteers would be there, so on and so forth. But every agreement that was entered into was violated. And it was very clear from the very word go in the morning that the intention of the farmers or so-called farmers was not quite...
Okay, final words to you, Gurcharan Das. is a dialogue still possible?
Well, I think personally, let's take this out of this. We'll forget all these things that have happened in the last 24 hours. What is important is what's going to happen next. And frankly, I believe that the government had initially they made a mistake by not having sufficient consultation in the parliament, etc. But after that, I think the government bent backwards. It tried its very best. And in fact, the last particular offer of the government was more than fair. I mean, if Punjab wants to carry on the way it does, India still needs to procure wheat because there's the food security bill. So there's no problem as far as Punjab.
Right.
Why must Punjab insist that the rest of the country must also do the wrong thing?
Absolutely, Gurcharan Das. We have really come to the end of this discussion. Thank you so much for joining us, Gurcharan Das, Neeraj Kumar, Adil Singh Bopparai, Zafar Islam, and Arthur Singh Sandhu. The sanctity of this movement is lost. The question is, can the farmers or those who are protesting at the three borders continue? Well, they should not. And can the government talk? We'll have to wait and see on that front. That's all from me. Thanks so much for watching.